And they call this the aha moment in the paper. And so you can see, you know, when you look at like its reasoning process here, it's trying to solve this math problem. And then it gets to this point and it says, wait a minute, you know, here's something important. I can flag this. And what's really crucial to point out is that they didn't actually teach the model to do this. It just kind of learned to do it itself, right? And this idea that these models can emergently develop these novel strategies is something that, you know, we've seen shades of in the past with different, you know, reinforcement learning strategies, like, you know, with Alpha Zero and things like that, but never really in the context of LLM fine tuning and chain of thought. And so this was really like a novel discovery that came out of this. And maybe last but not least, I'll just say that this, you know, R10 model, while it wasn't, you know, as strong as the R1 model itself, which was a much more complex training procedure, it was actually very strong. It actually beat O1 mini on a number of benchmarks across the board, and then, you know, was slightly worse on a couple. And then even the O1 model itself, it was competitive with and actually beat in a few cases. So, you know, this was a very powerful model that was trained with a very simple fine-tuning strategy based on reinforcement learning.